There's a major breakthrough. Errol Spence and Terrence Crawford are going back and forth on Twitter, and Oscar De La Hoya is chiming in. So I'm going to have all that for you, but first let's get to this. Errol Spence is telling Terrence Crawford, responding, because Terrence Crawford did a video yesterday, and in the end of this video, I'm posting the video of Crawford talking about the $25 million offer. So Crawford says he had a $50 million offer, $25 million for him, $25 million for Spence, not including a pay-per-view, just guaranteed $25 million. So Errol Spence says, all money, not good money. I asked Crawford, where is the $50 million coming from? Who is over the hedge fund putting the money up? He couldn't tell me. That's what Errol was saying. I think all we have to do is meet in person. So Errol Spence says that he and Crawford just have to meet in person to hash it out. And Crawford responds, LOL, you can't put that on your kids. Crawford goes on to say, you have asked about the back end and said you're going to talk to your people and see what they say. You're a whole fraud on my kid's life. You know you had to get permission to comment back. You watch my live. Now you got something to say. So Crawford says that. He goes on to say, and by the way, guys, there's a whole big exchange between Crawford and Spence. I'm going to do this in another video. I need to put all the puzzle together, but this is just the first video on this topic. And then I have another video of Oscar De La Hoya getting into it with Errol Spence over Al Heyman. But first, let's talk about this. So there's another thing by Spence. He says, I know why they had to drag this negotiation out. I know, and I heard from some close people to you what you be doing over there now. Get yourself together and stop doing that stuff, and you know what I'm talking about. So I have no idea what Terrence is talking about. Obviously, there's a lot between Crawford and Spence. They want to fight each other, but the fight's not happening. The fans want the fight. The fight's not happening. The boxing needs this fight, and it's not happening. So let's hope they get together. Like Earl says, sit down. Actually, Crawford says in his video that you're going to watch right now that he offered Al Heyman that he and his lawyer, Heyman and Spence, would work it out and knock out the fight and agree on everything, not come out of the room till they all agree on. So maybe it does happen. Maybe they all meet up and knock it out. But I'm getting a lot of feedback from fans that they're losing the patience with this fight. So if it doesn't happen, it's part of life. Life goes on. But here's what Terrence Crawford said yesterday that sparked this whole conversation. Check it out.
Guaranteed. Yes. They tell me, you know, be careful, make sure the deal is right. They tell me, make sure you don't get fucked. You know, just normal things from guys that's in they stable that I'm friends with. You know, I honestly can say I'm friends with. So, you know, we going on and on, you know. And, of course, me and Al, you know, we going back and forth about, you know, the numbers. We not going back and forth about anything else. We just going back and forth about the numbers. All in all, I have two companies, you know, that reach out to me that, you know, wanted to give me and Spence $25 million guaranteed. $25 million guaranteed up front. So a real guy like myself, I call Spence. Hey, bro, look, listen. You know what I mean? I got this company that's willing to give us $25 million apiece guaranteed. What's up? What you gonna do? He like, $25 million, what about the back end? I'm like, dude, listen. If they make their money back, then we get 80-20. You know what I mean? It's simple math. I said, man, we got people all still in the fight. They got the fire sticks. He laughed. He like, man, I got a fire stick too. I'm like, see? I'm like, man, ain't nobody really buying, you know what I mean, pay-per-views no more. I said, man, we get this upfront money, and we good. It's a no-brainer. You know what I mean? But one thing about me and the difference between me and the difference between Spence is I'm really my own boss now, and he's not. He got to go through Al. He got to go through, you know what I mean, his team and ask them if he can do certain things that I don't have to no more. Yeah, I might have had to when I was with Top Rank because I was signed to Top Rank and they was my promotional company. So, of course, I had to go to Top Rank and ask them to get me this fight or do this for me or do that for me, because I was obligated to do certain things by their standard because I was signed to them. But now that I'm a free agent and I'm free to do whatever I want, I'm the one sitting at the table. I'm the one that's you know, talking directly to these high individuals. Errol Spence not talking to, you know what I mean, Terrence Crawford about the fight. You know what I mean? Errol Spence wasn't at the table. Errol Spence can't tell you or show you a contract that, you know what I mean, says Terrence Crawford, Errol Spence, you know, that he was there on the negotiations of. He can't do it. You know, so he had to go back and ask Al for permission, you know, if he can, you know, take this big chunk of lump sum of money to fight Terrence Crawford, which he didn't call me back. So I proposed it to Al. I hit up Al. I'm like, Al, listen, you know, man, I got this big hedge fund company out here. You know, they claim they know you. Not one, but two. Not one, but two. You know what I mean? Two companies willing to put 20 plus million in both of our pocket, guaranteed. Al tell me straight up, I'm not letting nobody touch this fight. Like, all right, cool. But I'm like, why? He like, why would you want to put a ceiling on yourself? Why you want to put a cap on yourself? I'm like, well, that's not putting a cap on myself. If this company is taking a risk, then, you know, risk, higher risk, you know what I mean, high reward. If that's the case, you know, I can't seem to see a fight that's been doing millions, you know, since Floyd them. So, you know, that was an altercation, you know. I asked Al, I said, since this fight is dragging on with me and Spence and we can't get things together, why don't I come out and meet you with my lawyer and we just wrap it up? Just me and you and my lawyer. Al said, you know, his mother was, you know what I mean, not doing too well, and I honored that and I respect that. You know, family first. I'm a family oriented type of guy, so I know what it is, you know, to, you know, put your family first. So I'm cool with that. But then again, you know, as negotiations still drag on, and I had stated that I wanted to fight in this year, I asked Al again because we seemed like we wasn't getting nowhere. So I asked Al. I said, Al, listen, why don't you get Spence and you, since you his representative, and I'll get myself and my lawyer, and we just make this fight, you know what I mean? Anything we gotta do, we can do it right there and sign, seal, deliver. And Al told me straight up, that ain't never happened in the history of ever, where two fighters sit down at the table and they come to an agreement and they get a fight made like that. Not even Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao. So I'm like, okay, well, it's the first time for everything. I never heard of a fighter ever taking zero guarantee in a fight. I never heard of a fighter of a four-rounder taking 0% of a guarantee. That is something that's new to me, but that's something that I was willing to do to make this fight happen. You know, a lot of people, you know, they say, oh, well, Terrence, you ducked, or Terrence, you did this and you didn't want to fight Spence. I'm the only one that was taking all the risks. You know, I told him, all right, cool. I take no guarantee. I take, you know what I mean, the less end of the money. You know, whatever it is you want, I take it, because that's how much confidence I got that I'm going to beat that man. That's how much confidence I got I'm gonna beat that man. So, you know, even though I know I was getting fucked in the long run, I just, you know, wanted a little transparency. I said, okay, if I'm gonna bet on myself, and I'm gonna go against all the odds, then I wanna, you know what I mean, a little transparency. Of course, you know, I wanna be able to write off on, you know, things that's gonna affect my check. Of course, I wanna see if the numbers add up to what they telling me. You're not gonna go and it's just simple to me to think that a person will go in a business with a person 50-50 and this person would tell them, well, you got to give me 50% down and I give you 50%. And then you say, oh, well, I'm not going to tell you how much we really made, but I'm going to just give you this. You just got to trust me. Come on now. It don't make no sense. I never was offered a guarantee. Not once. I never, you know what I mean, was given anything. But here, you want this fight? We gonna fuck you, and then, you know what I mean, you got what you want. But you know, that's how much confidence and faith I have in myself.
Ellie Seckback reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com.
I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.